I heard motherfuckers saying they made Miz say, okay, so make another Miz. That's pretty much what it is right now. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you heard, but it's been brought to my attention that Money and Violence is no more. I don't know if it's going to be a new everything. I don't know if the name is still going to be Money and Violence. I don't think, you know, shit is looking real sketchy right now. Feel me? So what's going on is there's some type of riff in the set. Feel me? With the whole Cloud 9 shit. Feel me? As far as Money and Violence is concerned, there's some type of riff in the set. There's not a lot of people that was in Money and Violence is going to be in a new season. Feel me? And we ain't even talking about the niggas who he killed off. The nigga killed off half the fucking cast. So I was already scratching my head like, so the fuck is season 3 going to look like? My nigga, Jessica dead. Fuck. I told niggas. I ain't even going to say it yet. Well, I'm going to say it at the end of the video. Because it just hit me what the fuck is going on. But yeah, Jessica's dead. The Jamaicans is dead. Fucking, my nigga Black, the fucking Boz is life. That nigga raps every fucking, I don't know. Whenever it was dialogue between Black and anybody else, it felt like it was a fucking URL battle. Like, I seen Smack in the back throwing, feel me? Like, so he's gone. The Jamaican niggas is gone. Jessica's gone. Grimy Ty is gone. Shooter Shane is in the fucking coma. Boone is gone. Who else is it? Mad niggas is out of here, geez, like, and it's like, all right, that's cool. If you ended the series like that, I totally understand it, feel me? Let the fans and the audience just run wild with imagination. Like, nigga, we don't know what happened to Shooter Shane after whatever, feel me? That's for us to fill in the blanks type shit. But no, you want to come with the season 3 shit. Cool, fine and dandy. Let's not forget, Rafe did body one of the fucking, and it's like, yo, how can this shit, it got too big. It got too big. Because the way how that shit ended for season 2, niggas was on the edge of their seats waiting for season 3, bro. And now that the news is coming out, like, yo, it might not be a season 3, or if it is a season 3, it ain't gonna be with the same niggas. That's kinda sketchy, my nigga. That would require a lot of rewriting. Who knows? We might just see this fucking Rafe and Chopper shit, like, they might just link up. Because if Miz is out the picture, then what the fuck? Who the fuck is Rafe right-hand man? What are we going to get? Like, another fucking Respect Life or some shit? A dark-skinned Mello? A dark-skinned bald-head Mello? Come on, man. Nah. Mello's the only standalone complex when it comes to this hood web series shit. Feel me? That's the only nigga by himself with this shit. That's the only shit I could accept. But with this shit going on, my nigga, it was Rafe and Miz. Them niggas solo show. That's what the fuck niggas was buying into. I mean, Shane and, what's my other nigga? Kane. Shane and Kane. Wow, I never really noticed. Yeah, right. But Shane and Kane, them niggas was the go-to niggas too. Grimy Ty was another one. It was a bunch of so on. But most of them niggas is dead, or if not dealing with some real personal real life shit. Let me correct my shit. I'm not going to get in a nigga's business, and I ain't going to put it out there like that. Some niggas got locked up. But feel me? You guys need to do your research. Feel me? By the time this show is going on, hopefully niggas got out. But it is what it is, though. Feel me? Let's get back to this Miz shit, right? So I've been doing a little scouring and searching, you know what I mean? Putting a little few calls, you know what I mean? I know niggas that know niggas that know niggas that know niggas type shit, right? So, feel me? From what I've got to, well, let me just get to the Instagram shit first, though. So, Miz puts up a Instagram post saying, yo, he just wants to let the fans of Money and Violence know he will not be fucking with Money and Violence. He has to do his own thing. And so it was a lot of words that was, like, stuck out to me in this shit. Like, when the nigga said, you got to stand for something, fall for something. No, you got to stand for something, fall for anything. So I just said, shaggy. It's kind of, that kind of, it sounds like you're saying something without saying something there. So I'm like, all right, maybe I'm not. Maybe he just saying that shit just in general. Like, feel me? This was an executive decision. Like, everybody, a part of the team was like, you know what, Miz? I support you this and third. No, nigga, because I seen this nigga Rafe put up some shit. And I'm like, whoa. And the picture was harsh. I'm like, so what you saying? This nigga's like a fucking... Because if you look at the picture real closely, there's a nigga smoking a blunt. It's a black man with green eyes. So what you saying? They're like, that's all other niggas got on their mind is money. That's all they see is money. You looking at shit differently. Granted, you are, but my nigga, you can't expect niggas to go to, your own, to go to the beat of your own drum. Feel me? You have to be fair. You have to be balanced. Know what I mean? For this to work collectively, either we all follow in one order or we all respecting each other. You know what I mean? And the shit that's going on, it don't look like there's a lot of respect being shown. For example, I believe Miz is starting up some type of clothing line or some shit. It looks pretty cool. I ain't even gonna front. It's like an angel. It's like the Cupid angel laying next to a gun. Yeah, it sounds, but it's ill. I ain't even gonna front. I like the image of it. It looks pretty dope. One of the pictures he's saying, yo, shout out to my nigga Dune, blah, blah, blah. This is on the third. That's what real friends do. And I'm like, why is it? This shit feels real catty. Like, there's some, like, subs. But because niggas don't really know what's going on, it's like, niggas ain't really paying attention to it. Niggas ain't really talking about that shit. But best believe, nigga, that's what the fuck Mikel Schwartz is here for, you heard? Niggas is talking about that shit. So I'm looking at this shit like, these niggas are clearly going through a difference. Feel me? It seems as if Miz wants to pursue other shit. Miz has other things lined up. And because of the scheduling and timing for Money and Violence, he ain't got time for that shit. Feel me? Hint. This nigga Miz is going to be in a fucking Tupac movie, bro. What the fuck? You went from fucking YouTube to a fucking Tupac movie, God. Yo, son. Shit is crazy, my nigga. And it's like, who do you blame? Do you blame Miz for, like, pursuing what he wants to do with his life? Or do you fault him for not being a team player? Fuck you mean? If you making decisions on your own, my nigga, this ain't no fucking team. There's been plenty of interviews I've watched with these guys, and then it seems like my nigga Moses, a.k.a. Rifwat, is the fucking mouthpiece for the whole shit. If it ain't him, it's the other dude with the hat. I don't really remember. I think this nigga's like a producer, some shit that does the... He does something with him on Money and Violence. I'm not specific what his title is, but whenever you see an interview, it's usually Moses, fucking Renee, and then the other nigga with the beard and the hat, right? Sometimes you see fucking Dune and it's just Candy Cane, fucking Kane in the show and shit, in the interview. But for the most part, the mouthpieces of the interview are Moses and the dude with the hat and sometimes Miz, feel me? So that shit right there used to make me look at that shit like, shit kind of look like some New Edition shit, like, this nigga Rafe is fucking Ralph or some shit, and the other nigga is fucking, and Miz is fucking Bobby Brown or some shit. Like, shit was looking crazy. The nigga would say in interviews like, yo, it's all about time. It's not about money. This and third and time and more. He's expressing himself about, yo, what he envisions his show or his series to reach. These niggas is like, you see it in their faces. Like, these niggas is looking at people like, nigga, I got nigga family to feed. Got a family to feed. They dependent on me, nigga. What the fuck you mean by take your time? No, nigga, this shit hot. Sell it right now. Listen, man, I don't know about you niggas, but whenever you got some work, my nigga, sitting on that shit don't make no sense. Yeah, in your head it sounds good, like, yeah, I'm gonna sit on the work and shit. I mean, niggas gonna need it when there's a drought. I'm gonna come hit this shit, bro. Tomorrow's not promised for nobody. Feel me? I'm not saying the nigga's supposed to go out there and sign no wild crazy deals, but at the same time, you have to do shit for your team. Without your team, you would not be where you're at right now. Feel me? So it's like, yeah, I'm the brains, I'm the bronze, I created this shit. But without the support of these niggas and, like, everybody not playing their part, the machine wouldn't be moving. So you have to respect that, but I guess not. Feel me? So niggas is parting their ways and all that shit. So I hope the best for them. I hope niggas can work shit out, because I don't think Money and Violence will be the same without Miz and half the fucking cast that's dead. What the fuck are you about to do, like, some... I don't know, my nigga. T-Virus or some shit, bring niggas back from death, some Resident Evil shit or some shit. Like, I don't know, my nigga. Hopefully niggas figured it out, feel me? I know niggas is sock passe brothers and all that shit, so they could probably fucking talk that shit out and all that, feel me? As far as me, nigga, I'm out of here like bald heads, geez. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Sharing is caring. Violate the like button. I heard if you hit the like button so hard, nigga, season 3, nigga, Miz is gonna come back worth my, feel me? But word. I'm out of here, man. Thanks for listening. Ballheads, jeez. I heard motherfuckers saying they made Miz say, okay, so make another Miz. That's pretty much what it is right now. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you heard, but it's been brought to my attention that Money and Violence is no more. I don't know if it's going to be a new everything. I don't know if the name is still going to be Money and Violence. I don't think, you know, shit is looking real sketchy right now. Feel me? So what's going on is there's some type of riff in the set, feel me? With the whole Cloud9 shit, feel me? As far as Money and Violence is concerned, there's some type of riff in the set. There's not a lot of people that still...